enlarge the PPT, and then the bottom right.
Wait, where have I gone?
Yeah, next to the sliding scale. Yeah.
Wait, it'll come. It'll give it some time,
Yeah,
may it come.
yeah, 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 yeah.
And then stop
You
now.
just it requires a bit of a speed. That's about it.
Yes. Zoom is much faster. If I'm used more regularly. I've never used Teams before.
Right.
That's a problem. You have some advantage. Teams can you can record things much better, is it?
Teams is like a virtual university. I'm running, you know, literally everything I can do, all operations of a university.
That's why.
So it becomes much more conducive for record keeping, for the scoring marks, etc. Everything gets automatically done. Excel sheets get automatically generated. You can't do Zoom is good for webinars. But for classroom lectures and running a university or a class or a school, a team is better.
Can you see this presentation now?
Yes, can see this thing. Only thing is it's not coming as a large screen.
Yeah,
so you can
second.
Just.
Yeah, large screen, one moment.
Yeah,
is better?
This is perfect.
It's a slideshow matter now, mode
right,
now.
Right. Yeah,
okay.
Perfect. Now it's
okay.
Perfect.
I'm just seeing now my browser also. I'm going to show a video also, not just slide.
Right.
Now this is one video I'll be training video
oh,
I'm showing.
Oh,
you
wonderful.
Can see.
Yes,
huh?
Perfect. Perfect.
Okay. Start off with a video and then
oh,
we'll follow
wonderful.
Let's see. I hope I'll try my best to keep my time. I have not done a rehearsal. I just compiled the whole stuff.
No issues.
But I'll try and keep it.
No issues. No issues. No issues.
I used to teach long. I used to teach long ago at Tolani's.
Oh, okay.
So what a course thoda kuch kiya hai. So I know a little bit. I did one lecture, Zoom lecture with Tolani about 6 months ago.
Okay.
They like so. Theek hai, ho jayega.
I attended a workshop in Tolani. We all did. That was an All India workshop organized at Tolani by BST Trust. So it was a 3-day workshop. We stayed in campus at Tolani.
Okay.
And we used to attend the workshop from morning to evening. So that was my first visit to the Tolani campus.
Right. Lovely campus, huh?
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful campus.
I was there when it just started. Captain Krishnamurthy Iyer was here, was just appointed as the head of Marine.
Right.
And I was second person to start
okay.
the BSc Nautical. And it was a hell of a lot of work. You
okay.
know, basically, we are building work is still going on. The cadets
right.
are still coming. Nothing
okay.
is in place. Anyway, now it's become flourished into a real lovely institute.
Now it's, of course, it's a beautiful campus. And I have a couple of very dear friends there. Captain Indraneel Banerjee is there. He's the nautical science head. He's my batchmate from Rajendra.
Oh!
Right. So, 82, 83.
Right.
So then, of course, there is another faculty. He was there with me in extra master's class.
Sorry, one sec. You said you're 82, 83?
That's right.
Okay, then it's a different serene, yeah. We have to go back about 10 years, maybe oh, no, 8 years. He has to be 74, 76.
He's 74, 76. He's the other Sarin, 74, 76.
Okay. Still, anyway, nice to know you now. So, whenever you feel comfortable, you can
yeah.
I'm okay to start.
Yeah, another maybe.
So you're waiting for Kumar to say?
Just another 5 minutes more because the last class would have gone slightly long.
Slightly long.
Captain Gajanan, just wanted to share with you the earlier batches which had gone. We had a similar lecture. those boys are there on board now, and
हाँ
they reverted back to me from the ship, saying
हाँ
that we still remember that lecture,
हाँ
and we are making sure that all those things which were told to us about the pilot ladder rigging, we are engaging, and we are making sure that those mistakes are not repeated.
You know, Captain Sareen, these about whatever I am about to talk and about today is mostly also thanks to Gajanan. Had it not for my interaction with him about 5 6 months ago, I had not a clue about all the things which are supposed to be going, which are going wrong with the ladder. I was
Right.
happily jumping on board here and there. Means the basic things I knew, but the finer thing as to why certain things should be done, should not be done, and how they can be improved. I didn't know there's so much of, you know, effort has been done by people in the
Yeah.
continental area, with Arnie Palmer and Gary Clay and Kevin Valance, a lot of very seasoned
Right.
pilots, a lot of work. And finally, they found a very good solution. Very surprisingly, today what I'll be getting across to the cadets or to the mates is that
This is the
you have
base class.
regulations. You don't know, but it doesn't specify exactly how you're supposed to secure the ladder. SOLAS, IMO doesn't say that. So all kind of creative solutions have come up over the time, and they have become entrenched as habit, and they are causing issues, ladder failures and whatnot. And that's
Right.
not good. So we are trying now slowly, slowly, in the absence of amendment to SOLAS, which will take decades of effort,
Right.
long time it takes, and pilots are few and far between in the world. We are very tiny,
Absolutely.
tiny, minute. Nobody, you know, we are shouting in a, you know, far away on bottom, now Mount Everest is never reaching the top of shout. But here now, with this practical solution, call the cadet at the root only, train them up properly so that henceforth they have established good practices, you know.
Absolutely.
That's what you want to happen.
So we started this exercise sometime last year. Captain Gajanan proposed this, and we jumped at it, and then we tried all levels first with various batches. We tried masters, we tried mates, we tried second mates, we did cadets also. And then what my observation was that the mates level was the one which was the most responsive, interactive, and they were the ones who really understood the gravity of the whole thing. The cadets, unfortunately, since they have not yet been on board, they could not fathom and gauge the value of it.
These cadets, you know, they have to also be able to learn to speak up. These fresh fellows, when they go with all these new ideas, they
That's
have to
right.
now impose ideas on wrong practices which have been done already on board the ship. Now, can you imagine a young cadet
Absolutely.
going to a bosun saying, "You are teaching me? Huh? I'm younger than my kid. So he'll say, "Well, this is what they have to learn to it. Nahi, humko aisa sikhaya hai. Abhi tum badlo and change it."
True, true,
Well,
absolutely.
mates and existing
That's
mates
why
also.
that's
They have to have an
right.
attitude of humility. You must learn, always learn.
Absolutely. 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 Okay. Sajan, do we have everybody in the class? Okay. Yes, we do. So
If somebody can give me about, say,
yeah, we'll be giving you. Sure.
no, before, if I'm taking too
Yeah,
long,
of
it's a hurry
course,
up and
we'll
your
do that.
questions. This through.
No issues at all. We will give you an indicator. No issues at all. Is the class there now? Vivek
Yes, sir, we are there, sir.
Yes, sir, we are here.
Yes, we are there, sir. We are there.
Okay, great, super. We welcome Captain Janan, and an session today on pilot ladder rigging and requirements for pilots on board, as well as the safety procedures that should be followed for the rigging of the pilots. We've done a series of these lectures over the pandemic period since last year, and they have been very, very successful, and we've got excellent feedbacks from the ships. from people who have attended the lectures, and now they have reverted back to us. So continuing with that series, we welcome Captain Gajanan, Captain Pandey. Captain Gajanan, incidentally, has got a whole battery of credentials to him, to his forte. He is the president of the All India Marine Pilots Association. He is also a multimodal transport expert. He is a visiting faculty to the IIM on warehousing. He is a blue economy expert, social activist, writer, coach, and guest speaker. So without further ado, I welcome Captain Gajanan to ARI Saket, and we welcome you, sir. Sir, we can't hear you.
Yeah, I think your mic is muted, Gajanan.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Thank you very much, Captain Sareen, for this introduction. And, you know, I always feel that you speak more than what I'm not a great man as such. Of course, I don't bash about being a president of the AMPA as such. But anyway, AMPA has done quite a bit of work on these pilot ladders and, you know, creating awareness. Thank you very much for your campus, which we started last year on the pilot ladder lectures, and you being, you know, such a mentor there with the students and for the entire ARI, I'm sure the lectures go down very well. So most of the credentials go to you, and you're mentoring to the cadets and, you know, the chief officers and masters. We will start with this. I'll just introduce you a bit of AMPA's work so far. And AMPA is NGO which works for the maritime pilots in India. Idea is to work for a safety and security of pilots. So we found the very low hanging fruit was a pilot ladder, which was endangering pilots' life, having accidents, fatalities everywhere else. And due to the malpractices being, you know, carried out by the ship staff, probably crew on board, with respect to the securing of a pilot ladder. We inquired with MTIs, with respect to training, and then the best effort is to get involved in training. So I'm very thankful to pilots like Captain Pandey, who is a very senior pilot at Port of Dahej now. He has got a lot of pilot experience with him. I will shortly introduce him formally as well. But for people like him, the pilots like him came forward and said, yes, we are willing to train the cadets and, you know, the officers on board, even chief officers and masters, not for anything else, but for the betterment of global pilotage. Because, you know, all these guys are not going to go on the ships which are going to coast of the Indian coast. So definitely these guys are going to be there, you know, sailing on the ships which visits the, you know, various global ports. And the reports that we get from everywhere else that the pilot ladder are greatly non-compliance, it's really a shameful act, because the pilot, when he comes to board the pilot ladder, he has utmost trust in ship staff, and he risks his own life in climbing up because he can't see anything. He can't see from the pilot boat as to how the pilot ladder is tied, it is tied properly or not. He might see a condition of the ladder, whether it's old ladder, new ladder, you know, non-painted, painted ladder, good ropes, visually. But the main part remains the securing part, and main part remains the attending to pilot ladder when pilot is climbing up, and that way pilot can really cannot see. So he has utmost trust in you. So by this education, I think, you know, what Captain Pandey is going to do now is going to explain you the pilot ladder entire, you know, risk element in that. You guys being chief officers are responsible for training on board. So I would suggest that you take home the seriousness of this pilot ladder, you know, or pilot transfer procedure and a pilot ladder rigging procedure. Take this on board your ship, train your people like you do other drills, fire drill, boat drill. And I'm sure, you know, we have about 30 plus chief officers here attending. So I'm sure that, you know, 30 ships will be, the pilots will be safe in many, many ports to come. I have Captain Pandey here. Of course, Captain Pandey, he's a TS Rajendra 7375 batch. And apart from his sailing experiences, you know, in Sindhias and KC Shipping and things like that. He had a lot of liking towards the pilotage and, you know, navigation and, maneuvering ships and things like that. That made him a pilot. And he worked earlier in the Petronet LNG. He also worked at a Pipavav terminal for 10 years as a full tonnage pilot. And when I say full tonnage pilot, that means, you know, he has handled all sizes and tonnages of the ships coming into the port. And at the moment, he's a full-time pilot again at Dahej, at Birla Copper Terminal. He works with Ocean Sparkle. Apart from his pilot experience, of course, he's also a very good writer. He contributes to Empire magazines very well. He does things very meticulously, and, you know, he's a great supporter of Empire. And we are very pleased to have you, Captain Pandey, here. And I'm sure that students will benefit at large with your experience and knowledge and the things that you'll share as do's and don'ts about Pilot Ladder. So I will hand over the floor to Captain Pandey now and welcome all the students to pay their full attention, undivided attention to this lecture. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Captain Gajanan. Thank you, Captain Sareen. I thank everybody at FARI for having me here and making this possible. And welcome to all the students, all the prospective masters-to-be, ambitious boys you all are. A lot of safety of the lives on board rests in your hand and what you take away today from this effort to improve safety of pilot ladders. And without much further ado, let us start with the presentation. We'll start with a video first, a couple of videos. It is a kind of a quick overall view you'll get in the video, and then one or two real boardings you will see on videos, followed by a series of slides.
Sir, there is no sound.
Okay, I'll just see that.
So probably you just have to unshare it. And when you are again sharing it on the left side, there'll be an icon.
I think I forgot to do that. Thank you for telling me. Yeah. Unshare.
And when you share again, on the left hand side, there'll be an icon for.
I'll just say. I don't know why I can't come from detour. He'll be coming on, but my computer is a little bit slow.
Huh? Yeah, sure. It's come now. You can see now.
Okay.
Yeah, now the sound is there. Perfect.
With some indoor checks while the bosun lays out the pilot ladder for inspection. Let's see if the pilot ladder is certified. If you have a second pilot ladder, make sure that it is certified as well. There you go. As long as you're there, few more things to check. Check the planned maintenance system. When was it put into use? Check that you have an inventory maintained for the record of pilot ladders. If the pilot ladder was ever repaired, check how it was done and when. Make sure that it was inspected by class. Now, this is a tricky question. Where would you get this information? When was it inspected by class? Well, pilot ladder is part of your safety equipment certificate. The last SEQ certificate inspection date is when it was last inspected by class. There you go. That's the date we are looking for. Now that we have finished the indoor checks, let's go on deck and inspect the ladder. Carry out your physical inspection of the ladder. It should all be in clean condition. Inspect the side ropes and the wedges. There should not be any missing wedges. The side rope should have a firm grip. Make sure it is in order. That's a bad example. Should not be like that. Let's inspect the steps now. The steps should be clean. They should not be painted. They should all have non-slip surface, including the rubber steps. Check the condition of the rubber steps, that they are not cracked. Once again, they should be clean, firmly fixed. Spacing should be even. Look at that, a broken and cracked step. Make sure you don't have that. That's a very shabby ladder which could come off at any point. Make sure that the side of the ladder is marked with heights along the length. You can see 6 meters, 5 meters, 4 meters, and so on. We're going to inspect the spreaders now. Check the condition of the spreaders. There should not be any cracks. Should be firmly fixed. Spacing should be even. Let me show you an example of a very, very badly fixed spreader that's really dangerous. So this is the marking which relates your ladder with the certificate. It should be clearly marked. The pad eyes on deck should be color-coded with SWL, unlike this one, which has no markings at all. The pilot axis should be firmly marked on deck in clean condition. The duty officer must be checking this, unlike this one. The pilot ladder must be marked with tags for easy identification with your PMS. The length of the ladder should be enough to reach the waterline in any condition. Now that we have finished with the static checks, we are going to go for the rigging of the ladder. Let's rig it up. The rigging of the ladder must be done safely under supervision of a responsible officer. The ladder must be made fast on deck firmly using the pad eyes on deck, using strong shackles. There should be a life buoy next to it with a line and a light, but the line should not be connected to the buoy. It should be firmly resting on the ship side with all the steps touching the ship side, and the area should be free of discharges. Look at that ladder. It's a very poor rigging. None of the steps are touching the ship side. If there is a tripping line, there's a right way to connect it. It should not be fastened to the bottom part of the ladder below the spreader. It should always be above the spreader level. The illumination of the area should be adequate, which is usually provided by the deck lights, especially the searchlight on the bridge wings. People rigging should be wearing proper personal protective equipment, including safety harness, life jackets where necessary. The pilot ladder should be firmly fastened to the ship side. You can see there's a magnetic clip over here. There can be other systems to fasten it. That's a very, very wrongly rigged ladder that can come apart any moment. Now, the height above the waterline must be suited to the pilot's requirements, and it should never be touching the water. The pilot axis should be checked by the duty officer after rigging. There should be a safe axis for the pilot to come up. That's an example of a very, very unsafe axis. It should not be this way. If you are connecting man ropes, as required by the pilots, they should be between 28 to 32 mm Manila ropes only. Let's go for rigging a combination ladder and see what are the precautions to be taken over there. Now, if the freeboard of the ship is more than 9 meters, a combination ladder must be used. A single pilot ladder should not be used. Anyone who's involved in rigging of the combination ladder should always be wearing safety harness and life jackets. Proper PPE should be worn. Now, some ships are using a fall preventer device attached with a harness. This is extremely useful and increases the safety. The angle of inclination of the gangway should not be more than 45 degrees. That's the inclinometer of the gangway, as you can see. The gangway or accommodation ladder should always be leading aft of the ship. It should also be connected firmly, attached to the ship's side. The pilot's climb is expected to be between 1.5 to 9 meters, not less than 1.5, not more than 9 meters. And the pilot must be escorted to the bridge when he arrives.
Okay, now we'll see some interesting videos about boarding and some dangerous moments. This is boarding in very heavy weather. Requires great skill and practice. Here the pilot is totally dependent on the crew having provided a proper ladder, properly secured, in good condition. He's putting his life on the line here. For whom? For your ship. Doesn't happen every day, but it happens often enough on your ships. So when the day comes, you should be working properly. That is why you always prepare for the worst moments, not when everything is nice and smooth. Safe aboard. Sigh of relief. Let's see another one. Here there's a mishap, rather alarming. Again, rough weather. See how easily things can go wrong. There's only one, there's it. Life buoy without the line, that's how it should be. Line is afterwards when you're trying to bring him up. I don't know what happened. This is from the net. I don't know what happened. Finally, when the pilot picked up, what happened to him? How injured was he? Now we'll skirt to the presentation. That'll be the nitty gritty of today's lecture. Why this lecture? Because there have been too many fatalities, injuries, and repeated deficiencies in the rigging of the ladder, maintenance of the ladder, and understanding cause. This is a critical operation. 26% errors in rigging is very high, unacceptable. And this is from surveys carried out by the International Maritime Pilots Association. Recently, last 6-7 years, across the world, mostly in European and US waters. Other places like India, reporting is very poor. But we as pilots in my career, I've seen, we are not all that better. The root cause for such high error rates or deficiency rates is lack of awareness of governing standards and what are the correct good practices. So we'll proceed with our today's lecture in the sense in different sections. We won't talk about technical specifications and specific details of the rules and regulations. You would have learned all this mostly in your early certificate courses and in your pre-sea training. So we'll go about in three steps, several steps. First, we'll be about securing the ladder on the ship. I'm going to lay great emphasis on this because this is the crux of the lecture, how to properly secure the ladder. There's only one correct way. Then next, issues from rigging ladders too low, lower than what the pilot has asked for the ship, then there are special issues with people are unaware of transfers from vessels with low freeboard. Some of you might have to go on small tankers or smaller vessels, deeply loaded, say, feeder vessels, where the freeboards are quite low between the pilot boat and the pilot in the deck of the ship. So those things present special challenges, and the regulations are quite flexible. In fact, they're not very clear as to how exactly these transfers will take place. We'll talk about that a little later. And then there are, you should have a proper understanding of what is the criteria based on which we decide when a combination ladder is to be rigged. And then some other matters. So this is the ecosystem for the pilot ladder, pilot transfer arrangement. They are all interlinked. And as we know, the chain is as weak as its weakest link. So if you don't follow SOLAS, if you're not compliant, you're breaking that link, or complying with the IMO resolutions, or the standards at which the pilot ladder is to be tested and approved and manufactured, that also weak link. And then your operating procedures, your management practices, the ISM code, all this must mesh together seamlessly. Otherwise, fatal consequences can be the result. Now let's start with the first part of securing the ladder. The regulations specify how a ladder is to be secured to the ship when using it at its full supplied length. Means from the thimble eye, you attach it to the deck on the designated strong points with the supplied shackles. And the rest of the ladder, you put it over the side and hope that the gap between the lower step and the water level is as suitable for the pilot. That's a very small hope. It rarely happens. You have to adjust the length of the ladder, and that adjusted length is called the intermediate length. There are no specified guidelines as to how to secure the ladder for intermediate lengths, so that it suits the current freeboard and boarding position. So what does the ship's staff do? See, if they are very creative, very inventive, they found all kinds of solutions, and over a period of time, we found all kinds of accidents and bad consequences happening. Then we as pilots all over the world, some people have taken a lot of effort, and finally, by a series of trial and error and knowing how a ladder actually works, they've devised one method which this campaign of ladder safety is trying to establish all over the world. Pending proper specifying of how to secure ladder intermediate lengths in the SOLAS regulations or IMO resolution. That takes a very long time to get done. But in the meantime, dangers are being faced by the pilots. Dangers are being faced by ships, by when they don't get the pilot at the correct moment. At the critical moment, if he cannot board, the ship runs into danger. She may have already come to the past the abort point, and then you are in deep trouble. And remember, those days when you could carry out repairs to the pilot ladder on board the ship. Sometimes, I remember when we were cadets, we find the crew making ladders on board. All those days are gone, because seamanship standards have generally sort of decayed. So to overcome that, the rules now say that the ladder has to be obtained from an approved supplier who will get the ladders from an approved manufacturer. So they'll be properly certified, and only those ladders shall be used. So if a ladder gets damaged because of improper rigging or lack of proper care, the ladder, the pilot can refuse to board. And then if you don't have a ladder on board, you figure out how your ship is going to berth. You can see the costs, consequences of being careless and allowing a ladder to be damaged or deteriorate badly. So before we go to exactly how we should properly secure, we can see some of the securing methods which have creatively come up. One is that notorious little piece of metal which is put on the edge of the ship side, called the tongue. Some people call it deck tongue, other one call it a deck bracket. All that the crew has to do is just to jam the step underneath it, and lo, without any much further ado, the ladder is rigged to the height. Very simple to set, very simple to remove. Wrong. What happens is, when the strain comes on the pilot ladder, the step is not designed to take the weight of the forces which can exert on the ladder. It can snap and break, and the fixtures can get damaged, and it'll ruin your ladder. Once the ladder is ruined, you can't use it. You cannot just attach some scotch tape or do some very jury splicing. Not acceptable. Unfit means it's finished. You have to have a new certified ladder. If you don't have one, have in your stores, sorry, pilot won't board. Over here on the left hand side, they rig the ladder onto the ship's railing. That's not a strong point. That's not the designated strong point. The railing is very weak. It won't withstand the strains the ladder can be subject to. Here on the right, you have shackles being used to throttle the side ropes of the ladder onto the deck. So again, this is a very wrong method. This causes serious harm to these fittings and to the rope work. Very soon you have an unusable ladder, unfit for use. Here again, the fittings arrangements on the ship meant to have a proper stepping platform. Very creatively, they use this platform, these locking pins, just these locking pins as a means of securing it, thinking that you just plop the lid down and put the pin and that's it, ladder secured. Wrong. Very unsafe. Here's another one. Jamming a crossbar, similar to a deck tongue. Wrong. Putting the strain on the steps and the fixtures. They are not designed for that. Here another one. The spreader of the ladder is used as a jam against the opening in the railings. That is taking the weight. Wrong. Again, coupled with shackles. Not good. Not good. All will damage the ladder, and also in the process, pilot can also fall. So let's start with what should be done the correct way. This is what all the campaign is about. To secure intermediate lengths, a very simple rolling hitch method is available based on best practice. It takes into the consideration that the design and construction of the ladder makes the side ropes of the ladder as the primary weight-bearing part of the ladder. Meaning, whatever forces act on the ladder, they should be borne by the side ropes. The steps are designed only to take the pilot's weight, which is hardly 100 kilos. The side ropes can go much stronger, up to 24 kilonewtons, whereas steps can bear only about 8.8 kilonewtons. 24 kilonewtons means about 2.4 tons roughly, and 8.8 kilonewtons is hardly about 900 kilos, 850 to 900 kilos. Whereas 850 to 900 kilos, whereas 2.4 tons, big difference. And what is this weight? How can we say that the weight can be much more than 800 kilos. Pilot doesn't weigh more than 800 kilos. It is the weight of the pilot boat which accidentally during the process of transfer gets transferred to the ladder when it gets jammed between the boat and the ship side by wave actions during transfer. That is what we're talking about, and that is the cause for so many serious damage results to the pilot ladder, and also the ladder ropes failing and pilots falling, or partly the ladder fails and the jerk causes the pilot to fall off. All very, very nasty things. So that's why shackles, bars, tongues should never be used, because they don't put the weight on the side ropes, instead on the steps and the fixtures. They are not designed for such heavy forces. So here's a method what you're supposed to do, use dedicated rope props. Don't bring out a piece of rope every time, some new one from here, from the Boston store, after peak store. Dedicated rope props. These are also now many get good practice in Europe, especially. They want to see certificates for these props also. The test manufacturer certificate for the rope which you use, so you can identify it. The shackles have to be properly, they're suitable for use, tested, okay, with paperwork behind it. So dedicated props made like this, with a spliced eye, dedicated shackles. So all you got to do is attach the shackles to the strong point on the ship, and the rope is used to secure the pilot ladder across the side ropes by using a rolling hitch. Let's see further. Here it is, the rolling hitch. Naturally, this is the securing rope I was talking about, attached to strong points. Over here, they don't have a dedicated one. They just use two pieces of rope, but still, this is much better than all those tongues and rods and whatnot, all the nonsense. This is the correct, best way, best seamanship. We're not saying this is the official way. This is the best seamanship practice, and this is the best things which you can do to prevent your ladder from getting damaged or causing injury to the pilot while climbing or using the ladder. Obviously, these ropes have to be of equal length. No use having this one longer than the other. Then the ladder will slant, all the steps will be slanted. So, but easy to ensure. It's very easy to apply these knots. You have a shackle over here, and other end you just here. Put a rolling hitch. And how to do it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Very simple rolling hitch. You can learn within 15 seconds how to do it. Now we come to the next part, that is when you say rig the ladder, the crew have been told, okay, how high above the water? Okay, port controller said maybe 3 meters of water. But then they don't really check what the 3 meters. They look from over the rail down below and they sort of guess. Or maybe the trainee seaman, somebody says, yeah, okay, 3 meters ho gaya. But invariably they think, see, the ladder a little bit longer, we can always use a tripping line and pull it up. But if it's too short, then unnecessarily we have to again call the crew on deck and unshackle and do all this and then adjust the steps. Too much of a bother. Let's leg it a few steps longer only, and we'll use the tripping line. When the boat comes, we'll just pick it up. And when the pilot steps on board, that's when it comes close, we'll release the tripping line. So then no problem. Flexibility is there. But wrong. That's not right. That extra loop of steps which is there at the bottom, it snags into the pilot boat, or if it snags the pilot boat, God help the pilot, if the wave causes the boat to pitch and he will surely fall, or the ladder holds, he'll come crashing down and you have a disaster. It should not snag in the pilot boat. That is why the steps, the height of a water level should be as required by the pilot, and it has to be carefully checked. Failure to do so can also result in damage to the ladder in this manner. Here you can see the ladder rig on the side, a bit too long, very long in fact. The pilot boat coming alongside, the waves bumps its fender on the ladder. While it bumps, the force is this way. From resolving this triangle, this force, you find it one component downward. This is very heavy amount of this, much, much more than 900 kilos, much more. Okay, so this is what is exerting its weight onto the shackles and everything, whole spring strain. This is what is happening. And if it's not done properly, the fittings on top, if you will jam a shackle over here, that will tear. And you see the pictures. Yeah, I've explained here. This is how it was before the jerk came. Before the jerk came here. These are the shackles. Wrong method, but I'm just showing what happens. And when the jerk comes, say, one of the ropes, both ropes equally jerk, very rare, one of the ropes is going to take the actual jerk. Suppose it is this one. So this has got extra force downward here. What happens is, this fitting gets pushed, ripped off from the seizing, gets pushed. As a result, this elongates and the ladder becomes slanted. And when you want to use the ladder at another port, when you're ringing it for another different length, this becomes all wonky. In the end, you have a ladder because the jerk is a good ladder. And now after that boat action, this is the ladder which you have. Unfit for use. You can't repair it on board. You can't. Only thing you can repair on board are the steps, that too just by taking a approved step from the manufacturer, removing the damaged step and clipping on the new step. And that too you can have at the most two replacement steps, not more, not more than two. So if you have a damage like this, your ladder is gone, and you don't keep pilot ladders galore in your Bosun store or after peak store. No. And you can't get them just like that. Very tough. They have to come from approved manufacturers. So don't do all this. Secure using rolling hitch. So first thing is rolling hitch. Second one was securing at correct length. But how do you know what is the correct length? From how can you do it? You can actually physically make some, put some markers on yourself. But now you're, thankfully the regulations say that the pilot ladder, approved pilot ladders, shall be marked at every regular length, example, every meter. So here's one picture of a ladder. You can see the marking. This is 12 meters they put, probably at every meter, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, going all the way down. On the other side, whatever, depending on the length of the ladder, is regularly marked. So when now you know visually how long the ladder you're deploying minus the freeboard, at that point, that is what the height of the lower step will be from the waterline. 12 meters, height desired by pilot, 4 meters, 8 meters. So you have to see that the 8 meter mark is passing over the point from where it is going over the side. So then you'll find that the lowermost step will be 4 meters of water. This is a simple one. There'll be other complications when you have to do the same thing when a pilot ladder is suspended from a platform arrangement, trapdoor platform arrangement. So then how do you ensure that the lowermost step of that ladder in such an arrangement is the desired height above water? For that, you need to know the gangway angle, what will be the height of the lower platform of the gangway above the waterline at that angle, and from below that you would calculate your freeboard and so on and so forth. Accordingly, ladder has to be adjusted. So there'll be a presser. Somebody will have done the thinking, and approved procedure will be there. So that's what the red letter, the text says. Look at your SMS. If it's not there, tell the company and devise one method and follow that. I'm saying it's great emphasis should be there on rigging to the correct length, because that is where a lot of damage takes place, which you cannot repair and cause a lot of problems for you later. Here is what happens when the pilot boat jumps onto the ladder and puts its weight. This is what happens. You can see I showed you physically in the earlier one on the sketch. Here is one actual case. This is what has happened. The boat has jumped onto the ladder and it is on this jammed side rope. This is what has happened. It ripped this fitting down. This is what has happened. Here in this case, it jumped top of the spread over here. Too long. Probably it was very long. This is what has happened here. And here is an extreme case where, God knows, I'm just saying how the pilot didn't fall over here in the water. It broke. Of course, the ladder is in a very rotten state, that too. So that's about securing the ladder and ensuring that the length of the ladder is correct when we, as required by the pilot. Now let's go to low freeboard transfers. This photograph is of an image. Is offered from a case study in the UK where a pilot in the Port of London died. Such a simple thing, poor chap, he was disembarking. Instead of using this arrangement, he used the gate and just stepped across, thinking that he can manage. It was dark, he misjudged this height from this lip to the deck, 800 millimeters, more than 2 feet. It's quite a large jump. And he tripped and he fell in the water. And both were going at some speed in the darkness and in the waves. He died. Couldn't be recovered quick enough. What the inquiry said was, this is not the gate, should not have been used here. Instead, the ladder where it is rigged, those two stanchions, that is where what should have been used, so that he can, on the other side, there should have been a bulwark ladder the whole thing should be properly supervised. Everybody taking it lightly. Pilot, yeah, just go out and hop off. It's simple. That's it. No, you don't have to use a ladder also. That is a, what do you call? It looks so easy, but this is where the mishap happened. You took things for granted. Now from this death, people have should learn the lesson. Don't take even low freeboard transfers for granted. In fact, they're very tricky because you have to really time your jump and you have to be very careful. Things can happen in a flash. One moment you're on deck, next moment you're in the water. Because the small ships with such low freeboard, they're also quite themselves very jumpy in the water. Large ships are quite steady and for the pilot boat to manage. But small ships, you have the ship itself moving around heavily and the pilot boat becomes a very tricky job. And very tempting just to hop across. Should not. You're done with patience. So the pilot here should go on top of those railing. This should be with a bulwark ladder. Turns around, holds on to those stanchions and slowly goes down. So he has a hand hold all the way. He got a 4-point hold. And when he's ready, two hands and one leg on the ship and the other leg going across to the pilot boat. And he times his transfer so that the boat crew, which is there ready by, quickly catches him. That's how it should be done. See, another example. It's very difficult to maintain your balance. It's easier when your arms are above your shoulder height to grip the ladder, but here you find the arms are at, hands at waist level to maintain a proper grip and your balance, center of gravity. Using this is very difficult. Here the weather seems to be okay because both the ship as well as the boat seem to be upright, but when they're moving around this way, that way, very tough. So that's for low freeboards. This is what? When the freeboard is less than one, when the climb is less than 1.5 meters, that's what you're talking about, low freeboards or less. They're not compulsory to have a pilot ladder, but this is what can happen if you are very careless, not careful. Now let's understand a little bit about the confusion many people have about this 9-meter business. Now, if the freeboard is 9 meters, then the combination is to be rigged. But somebody says, well, if the pilot says rig the ladder 4 meters of water, and my ship's freeboard is 9 meters, so the ladder length will be 9 minus 4, only 5 meters. So why should I have a combination? I can just rig a simple ladder, easy for the crew, fatafat ho jayega. No, it is not that. Because when a pilot rigs, climbs such a ship without a combination, maybe he's climbing only 5 meters, but by the time when he gets to the top of the ladder, how high is he from the water? 9 meters. And were he to lose his grip or whatever, the ladder were to fail, anything, were he to fall, he will fall from a height of 9 meters, not from 4 meters, 5 meters above the water, from the 9 meters. So the maximum expected fall will be 9 meters. Because that is the height of the access point. And you can see from the table how bad it will be. You're hitting the water at 48 kilometers per hour. Can you imagine flat? It becomes like almost like concrete. It's as good as falling on concrete. The first one you see at height of 1 meter, you fall at, by the time you touch the ground or whatever, you're at 16 kilometers per hour. You crack your skull. You fall at that speed. If it's on the wall or something. So that is why it is the, you have to use, think that how high, from what height the pilot, if he falls, what will be the height? If it's less than 9 meters, then your rigging is fine. But if it's more than 9 meters, then it should be either combination or whatever. Now let's go to the actual combinations. The rules and regulations you know, but let's talk about the defects. That way it's better to understand how the rules can be understood. It says the platform should not cover, the left first picture says the platform should not overlap the ladder. Here it is overlapping. Can you imagine yourself going up the ladder and then you find, well, now there is a platform coming in your way and you can't go up. That's what happens. Next one is okay, but the tripping line is leading aft. You should be leading forward. Leading aft tripping line with snag in the pilot boat. Not good. Then you have the next one. The ladder height is 1.5 meters. It is not. As a result, when he goes up above the platform, the ladder will swing away and he'll have a tough time getting on the platform. The next picture shows, see how high up the pilot has to go first and handholds are required. And then he can transform to the lower platform. There's no use securing the ladder to the ship side at the same level as the platform. A few good examples will show what we mean. We comply with the requirements for rigging combinations. Left hand picture shows the ladder is secured well above 1.5 meters, about 1.5 meters above the lower platform with two of the magnetic attachments. Then there's a small separate attachment near the lower platform that is to secure the ladder combination. There's a gangway itself to the ship side. So the gangway also secured at the lower platform, as well as the ladder is secured, but about 1.5 meters above the lower platform, secure ship side. And the tripping line, of course, is leading forward. Ditto with the picture on the right hand side. Then we have another apparatus which is used on very large ships. We also on ships where they have a short crew, they have a pilot ladder on the winch reel. Beneficial for preserving ladder, storing ladder, but also has some issues. Especially if it's power driven. So the main thing is, don't let the forces acting on the side ropes or ladder get transferred directly onto the winch reel. The winch reel is not designed to take the forces which the pilot ladder will be subject to when being used. Instead, there should be strong points on the deck to which the ladder should be secured. And the other end, other part of the ladder, which is on the reel, that will be kept slack and clear from the boarding area. Here the left hand side picture. I suppose the next time, if any one of you go on board a ship which is of this type, or having this kind of fixture, you will not do this kind of rigging. You will not use shackles. Instead, you will use the rolling hitch and secure the ladder to the ship's deck using dedicated strops, shackled to the paradise and the other end attached to the pilot ladder side ropes using a rolling hitch. Right hand picture also same. This picture has copied the IMO poster. IMO poster got some problems. So the crew have followed the poster exactly, not their fault in say, but instead we are pointing it out that IMO poster also is under revision. You see these side ropes of the ladder, after from the ship side they're coming on board, they're going under two paradise. They're not lashed, they're just led through them and goes on to the winch. They're not secured on deck. So the weight of the ladder is coming on the winch reel. Not correct. Correct way to do it is to again use the dedicated strops, apply them just one end on the shackle, other one rolling hitch onto the side ropes. So that and the ropes to the winch should be left slack. And the winch must be locked. If they're power driven winch, it has to be locked. Even a mechanical winch also has to be locked so that it doesn't turn inadvertently. Then you have another one, very large ships, especially these big container ships and even car carriers, you have hull doors. These doors are much lower, closer to the road water line. Not so close as that the minimum height of 5 meters is compromised. They're above that, allowing some margin for seas. They're above that. But then some of them are just with a ladder going up all the way hung from deck on top. Or sometimes there's a winch within the recess of the hull door system. On the right hand side, there's a winch inside. So you want to calculate. So here again, this ladder is a long, very big ship. The hull door is lower, much lower than the deck level. Now the ladder can, there's such a long ladder, it's being secured from the deck, not at the hull door deck entrance. So on, it can easily swing around, whip around because of the height. So it needs to be secured to the ship side. And here are the pictures of a, not a proper securing. They've used secure only one side rope. As the pilot climbs up, can you imagine when he pulls the rope, the ladder is going to twist and make his transfer from the ladder onto the platform difficult. Either way, getting off also difficult. The ladder will twist. Not good. Then you have a trapdoor system. This is a where the pilot ladder is suspended onto the gangway. The gangway has a special platform, a large contraption, which is gonna opening, which is called a trapdoor. So the pilot walks down, or when he's climbing up the ladder, he passes through the trapdoor, and he has to have sufficient grip above the trapdoor to pull himself up, out, and then go on to the gangway itself. So in the upper picture, you'll find the ladder is terminating just under the trapdoor platform. So when the pilot has to go up, he has to negotiate one bar like an angle iron. Then there are some metal pipes which he has to hold on to. Those pipes can be slippery, maybe too large, and he can lose his grip. All very dangerous, very dangerous. There's nothing like a pilot ladder to grip and hold on to. That's the best grip you can get. All this pipe and money is not good. So that's a problem. Now this is something which is everybody now working on. Encouragingly now, even a very large company like Maersk have come up recently with a circular that they are going to fleet-wide. They have been asked all the ship staff, chief officers on board, to check whether the trapdoor arrangements are compliant or not compliant with the new good practices which are being circulated. And if they're not, then they're at the next whatever layup or something, they're going to get them all repaired or modified to make it good for the pilots, which is very nice. So some two or three big companies do this, then immediately the pressure comes on all the other laggards, everybody, this goes away. This problem will go away. Meantime, it's a bloody widow maker. So this is what you're talking about, making it compliant. You see the right-hand picture, pilot comes up, the pilot ladder continues. He can keep holding on nicely, have a proper pilot ladder to grip on, not some slippery pipes. And then he safely transfers onto the platform and then comes up the gangway. On the left-hand side, they have made a U-shaped sort of a crossbar on top. So instead of hanging the ladder directly under the platform, they have raised that crossbar by another 6 feet, 2 meters, so that pilot, when he comes up, he has a proper grip to hold on to before he transfers onto the gangway. This is the kind of solution which ships don't have this, they have to do this. It's not very difficult, not a very costly repair. It's just a matter of finding the right amount of concern and not just making lip service, but actually doing something about it. A little bit of push always helps. You guys go on board, if you find your trapdoor is not good, tell the company. Tell them Captain Pandey told you so. Now we come to the concluding part, the smaller details not to be missed out. is that transferring from the ladder onto the deck. Sometimes you have to go over a bulwark. So you have to have a bulwark ladder, and the bulwark ladder needs to be rigged in a certain way. It is not any old way. It is main thing you have to see is that the stanchions and the bulwark ladder are not combined to one unit. The stanchions have to be separate, and the bulwark ladder is a separate piece of equipment. The stanchions must be rigidly attached both at the bottom as well as on top, so that if you leave it only at the bottom, they are being long, they can easily bend and break. So it will be attached at two points, and the first rigidly at the bottom and also at some height on top. And they should be about 1.2 meters, sufficiently high above the bulwark level. So the pilot has enough height of stanchion to grip onto, as you can see, the pilot coming on board. So he can, without losing his balance, climb on board the ship. Get on, transfer onto the ship, onto the deck. So here's a question. I'm answering here, but question is, I think about it. From which point will the freeboard at the boarding area be calculated? From deck level or from top of the bulwark? So if you understand that it is a height from which the pilot is likely to fall, that matters. So if he falls, he's going to fall from top of the bulwark. So as far as the pilot is concerned, in 9 meters, the rule is start from top of the bulwark and not from the deck. From the deck, it could be only 8 meters, and you might just rig a plane ladder. No. You have to use height on top of the bulwark, and that is 9 meters or more, then you should be having a combination ladder. Obviously, in this picture, it is the height of bulwark is less than 9 meters. So the word freeboard is a misleading word which is used in the poster. Freeboard, people think when they learn load line rules, this means different. It goes up to height of the deck, the edge of the upper deck from the very middle. That's what it is to the keel. And minus the whatever the at summer draft, that's what it is. But here in this case, freeboard is a different context. It is for calculating the fall, not the reserve buoyancy of the ship. And then we come to another thing, a safe approach. If you have an arrangement like you have C on the right hand side, where you have only a short gap between this fixed steel fendering which is on the ship side, then this is to be pointed out and is to be made into your defect list, and is to be opened up to 6 meters as shown in the left hand picture, so that it complies with the requirements. Why? So that the pilot board doesn't, edge of the pilot board doesn't snag on these fenders in the waves. And boats have been known to topple over, capsize. One wave catches it and tips it over, and when it gets snagged, wants to come down, but the fender is caught under the pilot board's fender, and the wave recedes, and the pilot board, next thing you know, is turned 90 degrees and is overturned. One, in a flash, it's overturned. Very dangerous. Very dangerous. Or it can cause severe damage to the hull of the boat. It can split open. So, very bad idea for the boat to come alongside in these kind of things. Not good. It should be done away with. Class might be involved, but it's for owners to do, and they should be advised to do it. Then we talk about tripping lines. Tripping lines should be attached only if they're needed. Don't just put it there. Even for some of the pictures, you see that the tripping lines are attached even with the ladder level, hardly 5-6 steps. I don't know why they grew up to do that. It's used to pull back the ladder after visiting. Transfer taking place. You want to secure the ladder, pick it up for sea. Then your tripping line is used so that crew has an easier time hauling it up. It is not meant to adjust an overlong ladder. That is not the purpose of the tripping line. The only purpose of the tripping line is to pick up the ladder for restoring after it is used, after the use is finished. It shall lead forward. If it leads off, what will happen? Because the ship is moving ahead, the pilot boat will come from aft, after the boarding position. And if the ladder, if the tripping line is leading aft, so instead of having a clear working area, the tripping line might foul with the pilot boat. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Excellent.
Super,
the
sir.
First in my mind is that.
Thank you all for listening patiently. I'll be open up for questions now. I'll just stop sharing.
Then after such a detailed explanation, I don't think anyone would be having any questions.
All right. Well,
so that's your first feedback, sir.
All right. Who's this speaking? I would like to know.
Sir, this is Bhojraj Singh Shekhawat.
I see. And you are? You are one of the mates. You are one of the students.
Yes, sir. I'm doing phase two now with ARI.
Ah, right. Well, I hope that when you go on board your ships, all of you who listen to this lecture, when you go on board your ships, never use shackles, tongues, and bars and whatnot. Use only a rolling hitch. That will go a long, long way in conserving your ladders first. Let us never mind the pilot's life. It'll conserve your pilot ladders. It'll save a lot of cost to your owners. Because if you found that the ladder was not in good condition, it can be easily found. Your inquiry can make out whether damage was existing, pre-existing, or occurred recent. You can make out old damage. And you find out that the wrong practice for even use, shackles galore, tongues galore, you find the ladders, all those chocks all worked loose, and you find all wobbly. And there you are, you have an imperfect ladder, and your owners are in trouble. You are in trouble. If your pilot has died, you will be charged with culpable homicide. All these kinds of issues come up. You cannot repair these ladders on board anymore. Neither the crew has the seamanship skills, and nor do the regulations, because of that, they don't allow you to. You have to replace it. And you can't get ladders in a very blink of an eye. You have to pray. Maybe owners, if he has said you can't have, don't have a ladder, you have to arrange a helicopter and lower the ladder with a winch down onto your deck, and you fix it, and only then the pilot is on board. Do you want that to happen? No. Use a rolling hitch. Such a simple solution. And rig it to the correct length. Don't use the tripping line and use it up for a pilot dagger. Just pull it up. Those are two main things I want to emphasize. The two main things which happen to damage the pilot ladders. So, is it too much information? You're still settling in that you can't ask a few questions? Well.
Any questions? No questions, sir. Okay.
I think this was the most perfect.
Sir, question. One more question, sir. Excuse
yeah, me. Please go ahead.
Ah, good.
This is Bhupender, phase two candidate, sir. Okay. Sir, I want to ask about this while living combination ladder. What about the securing of this this pilot ladder and this accommodation ladder, sir?
Yeah. The lower platform of the combination is attached separately by a magnetic device, or they have sometimes dedicated sockets are there on the ship side. So if the ship rolls, the ladder won't swing around. Okay, it won't pivot on the upper platform, won't swing out. And simultaneously, the pilot ladder, which is very close to that lower platform, that also is hanging, can move around. So that also be secured by another pair of devices, either magnetic or sockets, those can be secured. Now that securing is done about 1.5 meters further up from the lower platform. So as a pilot, when he climbs up, he'll climb up, his head will come up to the level of the combination of the lower platform, his arms will continue stretching up, he'll work his way up for a few more steps, for which his hand needs to go at least 1.5 meters above the lower platform. Once he reaches there, then his feet will be level with the lower platform, and then he can have a three-point connection, one hand on the ladder, 2 feet on the ladder, then one hand gripping the railing of the gangway, and then smoothly going across. Then one leg across. So there's a framed way how we do it, but essentially that's how it is secured. Separately, the ladder is secured about 1.5 meters above the lower platform, and the lower platform itself is secured to the ship side.
He's probably asking like old way of securing methodology, where the lower platform was supposed to be earlier tied to a ladder, and that is no more allowed. Bhupender, in case you are confused with that kind of a tying up is not allowed now, you know. And you being the second, I mean, mates candidate, you know, you guys should think of, you know, applying your mind to as to how it has come into force. You know, when you step onto the platform, there's a resultant force on your left leg going, you know, swinging the ladder past the platform. That's why the ladder has to be secured under the ship side, you know. So it doesn't swing. It doesn't go away.
Now it's clear, sir. That's what I was asking. This is the good clarification for me, sir.
Actually, yes, what's your name again?
This is Bhupender, sir.
Bhupender
Moore.
Okay. It'll become very clear to you. You secure it like you thought you should secure it, and you try and climb the ladder, and you'll find how difficult it is. Ladder will twist around, and abhi maa pe ghus gaya.
Same thing, sir. Because few minutes before you explained that this is stone, or this is the forces comes down, then this will damage to the accommodation ladder also. If we tie this one with that.
Yes. Correct. Those trapdoor arrangements, I don't know how strong they are, because when the weight of the pilot boat comes onto the ladder, it's going to transfer the trapdoor arrangement to the falls. And that can also be happened. There is a talk of having preventer wire. When you rig it, you must have a preventer wire also rigged onto the, to prevent, like a safety line. In case the falls break, the preventer will take the break. Something like that is there. There is
that is a class requirement. It's preventer a class requirement for any ladder.
But one thing at a time, first learn how to use rolling hitch, apply that, take away the shackles. That will solve 90% of the issues of damaged ladders, bad ladders, rotted. You know, the ropes are frayed, the ropes are very chewed up because of shackles and tongues and so on and so forth. That's what it is. And the height, then the steps are crushed, low steps are crushed because the ladder is too long. If it's a few steps shorter, it's very easy. Just put the crew on deck and lower it down. But if it's too long, then you have to pick it up. A lot of weight is there. So you should have some crew on deck when you're actually doing the transfer for these issues. Sometimes in the wave conditions, the pilot may have estimated 3 meters. But when you find the weather is further deteriorated, you say, no, 3 meters is not good enough. Please have it 4 meters. So then you should be prepared to do that. And if you don't have crew on deck, say, usko bulao, so kya aega, upar aega, you're already inside the port by then. Oh, she's done around. You missed that boarding point, you have to abort. So these issues, you should have crew on deck, quickly adjust, and so on and so forth. There's a lot of teamwork involved, and the pilot's place there lies in your hands. And the hands of the pilot boat crew. So from that end also, from the shore side also, a lot of skill is required. And pilots also, of course, beginner pilots might jump across too much prematurely, like the fellow fell in the water. I showed in the beginning video. Somebody who's more attuned to it, he'll wait patiently until he goes on board. And he'll live to tell the tale and lecture you guys. Unfellow, poor fellow might fall in the water. Iska kahani khatam. So, thanks for listening.
Vivek, you wanted to ask something?
Yes, sir. Just one more thing, sir. Like the height above the water level, of the lowest step is considered also for the vessel if the weather is too rough, because the vessel will be also rolling, the boat will be also rolling. So pilot considers that rolling of the vessel also?
Yes, he allows that he sort of works on an average level, to sea level basically, so that when you lower the ladder, when the waves are kissing it or catching it, you can always tell the pilot, sir, the at this length, which height which you have rigged, we have made a calculation and we put the lowermost step as per our calculations, it is at this height. But then with this heading or the whatever, the course which we are on, the rolling is there and the ladder is time to time it is touching the water and it is being pulled by the wake. The ship is, the water rushing past. So you pull away. Then you tell the pilot, he says, okay, captain, in that case, change your heading and let me know if the ladder is behaving properly or if you're 10 degrees this way, that way. If it's still not, then okay, shorten the ladder. Or finally, if it's still not, then we abort. We don't board, thing like that. But it is rigged for a, you must do the calculation using the written calculation, like I showed you. What is your current height above the water at that bulwark or the deck at that boarding point, minus your draft at that point, not your half draft or forward draft, draft at that point, that is your height above the water over there at the boarding. And then you subtract the margin which the pilot wants clear from the water, and that is the length you should pay out. When you pay out, you have to have marking of the ladder. That's why you have approved ladder. They got marking nowadays. You lower the ladder to that height and you won't be wrong. And that is why some responsible officer has to go for this. It cannot be the bosun jara laga ke 4 meter upar. He doesn't know all this. Or if you have, you are confident, you trained him in all this and you have seen him do it properly, then probably the next time you can say, okay, tumko malum hai na, haan kar do. Then you can say. Otherwise, if you are responsible for this, you must ensure it is done correctly. And when you, somebody says, oh, we check, wo kar diya, all you know what to do is when you go on deck to check is, as per your calculations, is the ladder 7.3 meters above, but you find it is 8 meters. It is too short or too long. You have to adjust it. This is to be done well in time, not just 15 minutes before boarding. The crew is called out on deck. Things can start going wrong. This is where your procedures have to be geared up towards preventing any mishaps and doing it right the first time. And getting your crew to do it right the first time. Otherwise, every shop you have to keep on checking and rechecking, and you're all the tension all the time. Barabar kiya, nahi kiya, fir se mujhe check karna pad raha hai, barabar nahi kiya. This is crucial. This is what supervision means. It is not just go out there on deck with a walkie-talkie and escort the pilot. That's not supervision. It is the rigging. Rigging has to be supervised, and later on the escort has to be there with walkie-talkie. That is true. And the walkie-talkie doing rigging also is important, because somebody falls overboard is dangerous work. Somebody falls overboard, instantly you should be able to communicate to the bridge that seamen were there working over the side, especially combination ladders, is very dangerous work. Just as pirates fall in the water, then many crew have lost their lives falling, doing rigging pirate ladders, combination ladders especially, going over the side. You don't hear much about them, but there are PNR circulars, so on, which happens. You lose a crew member overboard like this, rigging a pilot ladder, it happens. And then you say, well, if there's a walkie-talkie communication, immediately more quicker action could have been taken to rescue him and so on and so forth. But if it's just your procedures say, jao, do aadmi jao, cadet jao, karke aao, I say, no, it should not be that way. So all the SMS procedures which you saw in the video right in the beginning, they are important, not to be glossed over. And as chief officers, you will be grilled if something were to happen. Or if in your watch somebody are responsible for injury or damage or loss of life, maybe you might get away, but you will carry that thing in your conscience for the rest of your life.
Understood, sir. Thank you very much for this lecture. And just for information, sir, I have done multiple pilotages with you. So it was wonderful to have a lecture from you.
Oh.
Yes, sir. Dahej.
Dahej, all right. On which ship? Yes. Which ship?
Sir, last time I was on Aseem, but couldn't see you there. But before that, I was on. Before that, yes, sir. Before that, I was on Desha. I had done multiple pilotages, so it was wonderful to have a lecture from you.
Thank you. Well, one point I like to add: at Petronet, we don't use pilot ladders. We use only the gangway.
That is correct, sir.
It's a very special practice. It is. It's the same practice. Again, it is, you can't have a one size fits all. So over that port, gangway is the best thing. LNG ships are huge. The sea conditions, wave drag, such a is very beautiful arrangement it is. So you guys actually have lost practice of how to rig a ladder.
Your ladder that is lying, correct. So it was
the ladder is lying almost brand new as far as I'm concerned, the head is concerned.
So that is why it was very important to learn all this from you, sir.
Yes, yes.
So very good refresher of these things you have, and new things I have learned. Because we don't rig pilot ladders as such there.
Good, good.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Well, I'm glad you.
Excellent.
Thanks. Yeah. Nice to know.
Very informative session, sir. Very informative session.
Thank you very much. Okay. Thank you. So, are we done?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Absolutely. Thank you very much, Captain Pandey, for a brilliant lecture, I would say.
Thank you. Thank you. My pleasure.
You just had an amazing session. Amazing is the word.
Okay, Captain Gajanan, also nice. We'll do it again day after tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll do another session whenever you tell.
Friday
is the time, no? Friday
11:30, done. Yeah. Perfect. We'll have another class.
A different batch, is it?
That'll be a different batch. That'll be Mates Phase 1.
Okay.
That's another batch.
So anything which is not clear or something needs to be shortened, those guys...
Nothing.
I think it's
bullseye.
Yeah. Excellent. Very good. Very good. Thank you very much, Mr. Pandey.
Thank you.
For this session. Thank you very for the opportunity.
Yeah. Gajanan, thank you.
Thank you, Captain Gajanan.
I'll take your leave now. Bye-bye.
Look forward.
Bye-bye. Yeah,